Baker Boy.
If the last year's proved one thing, it's that Indigenous artists are really blowing up. With red-hot talent from the likes of King Stingray, Thelma Plum, and Electric Fields. First Nations artists are taking the nation's stages by storm. Dan Sultan stands tall among them as one of our most enduring talents, advocating for his people for nearly 20 years. Tomorrow, Dan will headline Share the Spirit Festival to commemorate the impact of colonisation on our First Nations.
Tartan feathers laying low on the land.
We love having him on the desk. It's Dan Sultan. Tell us about Share the Spirit. What's the message you'd want Australians to take away from the day?
I'm not really sure about the message I want Australians to take away. I mean, I know the message that I personally will be sharing is, you know, firstly, I'll just say I speak for myself as an individual.
Sure. Yeah.
And as we are all individuals, I think when we look to one person to speak for an entire group, it's a bit dehumanising, I find it. And, you know, some pretty appalling things have been done to my people after folks have been able to make that leap to dehumanisation. So, I mean, that's the first thing. I mean, that being said, tomorrow I'm going to be singing some really beautiful songs on a beautiful day in Naam, in Melbourne, and I think positivity and being able to do something positive and beautiful and to be able to create something like that and to create rather than destroy is a very powerful thing.
Yeah.
And I think it's lasting as well in a really positive way. And, again, I only speak for myself and that's how I prefer to approach things. And tomorrow I'll be singing a lot of new songs. Oh. And a few old ones.
Ah.
There's been a bit to write about. I've got a couple of beautiful little kids and I'm away from home at the moment and I miss them, so it'll be extra emotional tomorrow, and particularly on a day like January 26th. It's already so emotional anyway for myself and a lot of us. It's going to be great.
Well, yeah. Dan, we are, of course, keen to touch on the new music in a moment, but the way in which you personally view Jan 26, I've seen you coin on your platforms a term called Survival Day, and I'd love to hear a bit more as to how that came to be and perhaps when you started to kind of view the day with both survival and thriving.
Yeah. I mean, survival is something that's been used by a lot of people for a long time who have not only survived something but are thriving within themselves and their story. So I certainly wouldn't claim to coin anything particular. I know what you're saying, though. I did put the word day after it.
Yeah.
So,
well, it's important, given it's about a day.
Well, it is. It's tomorrow. That's the day. For me, I feel very fortunate that I have a gift and that I'm able to use that gift to put food on the table for my babies. And my wife and I are able to work with something that I feel is just so special. I mean, yesterday I was writing a song with a friend and, you know, before we went in, that song didn't exist, and then you come out at the end of the day and I've been singing it all day and I've been playing it to anyone who'll listen, and I've got it here, actually. I'll play it for you guys. And, you know, and it's just such a beautiful experience to be able to do something like that, you know. And so for me, that's what the thriving is. And, you know, it's survival. I guess we're all surviving to some extent, something. For me personally, it's, you know, things can be very difficult for us, and a day like tomorrow, for it to be for it to exist and what it represents for us, and then for it to be such seen as such a party, you know. It's really cruel. You know, there's some people that at the very least it's cruel, and at the very most and the very worst it's appalling. There's some people that like it. There are some people that like that. That's the day that started the genocide of our people, and that's why they want it to be Australia Day. You know, it was first brought about, you know, a lot. I can see my wife at home going, stop saying you know. It was first brought about by the Australian Natives Association over 100 years ago as an idea of this should be Australia Day soon after Federation was signed. And this is an exclusively male, exclusively white organisation at the time, and that's them at their core as well, who championed the White Australia policy, something that is in some form or another still very prevalent in this country. You know, I just know two friends who married people from other places, and one's from England and one's from Vietnam, and it took a lot longer to get approval for residency than it did. You know, so in some form it might not be an official policy, but it's something that's pretty prevalent for a lot of people still. You know, so I think if you say that you love it and you want to lean into it, then I think it's important to know what it is. And it's a day that was brought around on this particular date by a group of white supremacist male chauvinists. Now, that's, you know, that may not represent the same thing for people now. I've heard people talk about when their parents were sworn in as Australian citizens, and obviously that's a special day for people. There's a lot of things. I mean, I know someone whose birthday it is who had a go at me saying, it's my birthday, you know. So it's, of course, you know, but it's, you know, I understand the argument for abolish the date as well. I mean, we live in a country which treats First Nations peoples, you know, appallingly. And so any day celebrating any kind of nationalistic day like that is insulting to a certain extent. I'm not quite sure where I am on that. I think personally, if we're going to have a day called Australia Day, I mean, there are less cruel days to have it on from a First Nations person's perspective.
Totally understandable. And you've given people something else to lean into tomorrow, and you said you want to bring joy, and so that's a massive contribution.
And now we're going to go and sing some sad songs at the Lion Music Bowl.
Yes. But also some great ones.
So. Yeah, you can catch Dan.
Oh, they're great. They're beautiful. Yeah.
You can catch Dan at Share the Spirit Festival. It's at Melbourne Sydney Maya Music Bowl tomorrow. Dan, thanks so much for joining us today.
It's my pleasure.